The Outlaw OHV trail system located in Vernal, Utah has a trail for everyone. From riding the sand to rock crawling, high alpine forests to peaceful scenic trails. Today we'll take you on a guided tour of one of these trails, the Red Mountain Moonshine Arch Loop. This 20-mile loop typically takes about 5 hours and offers riders the experience of a lifetime as they navigate multiple technical obstacles along the route. Those who are up for the challenge will be rewarded with amazing views, historical sites, and a beautiful sandstone arch to explore. The Red Mountain Moonshine Arch Trailhead is located only 15 minutes outside of downtown Vernal, Utah, and begins at the Docks Beach Trailhead. Sections of this trail are rated difficult and extreme. Riders should be experienced and comfortable tackling multiple rock obstacles along the routes. We join Mike Cook with Uinta County as he leads us on our ride of the Red Mountain Moonshine Arch Loop.
Welcome to Uinta County. We're gonna do a trail of the Outlaw Trail System today called Red Mountain. It's about a 5-hour loop. It's a fairly advanced trail. We should have a lot of fun. This trail's an awesome trail. It's good for about any user. Side-by-sides, four-wheelers, motorcycles, Jeeps. We've got some of pretty much all that today that's gonna go with us. So as long as you're an experienced driver and have somebody with you that's familiar with the trail, you should be able to go and do this trail and have a lot of fun. Looks like everybody's ready to go, so let's hit the trail. Come on with us.
Leaving the Docks Beach Trailhead, riders will encounter sandy twists and turns as they head out across the lower elevation towards Red Mountain in the distance. This first section of trail is suitable for riders of all abilities. The first obstacle we encounter before ascending Red Mountain is a large downhill slope. The steep hill is an exciting challenge and a great way to get the ride started, as there will be many other challenging obstacles to come.
So we've been coming up getting to Red Mountain. We've had a few obstacles, little obstacles, and we just came down this hill that from this angle it doesn't look too bad, but it's got a big old ledge in it, stands you up on end, it's pretty fun. And that's the easy stuff. So we're gonna run on up and start hitting the more serious obstacles. If you come to here and you're just scared to death, might be a good place to turn around.
As we climb the rocky edges of Red Mountain, the first major obstacle we arrive at is called the Stairway to Heaven. The trail climbs over large boulders and a rock ledge, which creates a formidable challenge for even the most seasoned of riders. The key to overcoming this obstacle is reading your line before attempting. As these boulders shift often, you'll find a new challenge each time you climb the stairway. The climb to the top of Red Mountain is a bumpy scramble that takes riders over a variety of multiple obstacles. The approach will vary for those in your group, depending on vehicle length, width, and abilities. There are many bypasses, but some obstacles cannot be avoided on your way to the summit of the mountain. When you find yourself nearing the top, the scenery changes around you. Massive ponderosa pines loom overhead and to the sides of the trail. Our next stop in our route is the Red Mountain Overlook. This is a perfect place to take a quick break, grab a drink, and take in the near 360-degree views of the landscape around you. From this point, you'll be able to see the route you took from the beginning of the trail. A short distance from the overlook is an old cabin. This shady forested area is the perfect place for riders to take a lunch break. This old cabin gives a glimpse of what life was like in the old days when loggers worked this landscape. As always, remember to take only pictures and don't leave your mark on stone so we can preserve this experience for the next generation of riders. As you drive through the tall ponderosa pines after the logging cabin, you will begin your descent from Red Mountain. After a short period of time, you will reach the mountain's largest and most feared obstacle, Commando Corner. Following a series of down climbs over steep rocky passages on the edge of a large drop-off, you'll have no other option than to tackle Commando Corner. A large pinyon tree and a rock ledge leave just enough space for riders to navigate down a steep, multi-level decline. Choose your line carefully here, and look to see how others who came before you have approached this obstacle before proceeding. Once you've conquered the infamous Commando Corner, the trail quickly decreases in elevation over rough terrain, loose rocks, and slick rock. Riders will see Steinecker State Park in the distance below them, as well as the beautiful sandstone landscape. The Moonshine Arch Trail is an optional add-on to the Red Mountain Loop, but one that is highly suggested. This short detour will take you to view a massive sandstone arch that is unlike anything you've seen before. This is the perfect place to take some photos and unwind from the rattling descent from Red Mountain. Please remember that this route is also utilized by hikers and bikers. Please keep speeds low while on this section of trail and yield to all non-motorized users. With 20 amazing trail miles behind us full of obstacles, scenic overlooks, beautiful ponderosa pines, historic sites, and Moonshine Arch, it's easy to see why Red Mountain Trail and the other amazing trails in the Outlaws OHV trail system attracts riders from all over the world.
So this is Red Mountain Trail. We've had a great day and we hope you'll come out and visit us and ride some of our trails in the Outlaw Trail system. Please, if you want to come out, visit us online, get the information you need, and we'll see you out on the trails.
Plan your next OHV adventure in Dinosaur Land and experience Vernal, Utah, the origin of adventure.